Hello, welcome to day three, and welcome to my blog. Teach yourself test automation, right? Day three is all about setting up your first Java project, right? Your first Java project template, right? This one is it's easy and straightforward, and where you do this, you have to do this in Eclipse, right? So this is our Eclipse workbench. We'll have installed this on day two. So just launch your Eclipse and get into the workbench, okay? Now, a Java project, it just holds your test cases, right? So it holds your suite of test cases. That's all. That means within the Java project, you keep all your test cases, right? So, what is a Java project? A Java project is a collection of test cases, as I just said. So, a project can be called a test suite, or collection of test cases, right? So, now, how do you create a Java project? So you head to your Eclipse. Sorry about that. You head to your Eclipse, and you click on File, New. And you click on project, right? And you have a pop-up anytime soon. Boom, that's it. So, file new Java project. Create a Java project pop-up window launched. Name your Java project, right? So, we'll name the Java project My First Project. And you click Next. Now you notice that in there, that's your project created, and you have a wee folder, right? That's called the source folder, right? So you just click Finish. Now, to the right, to the left, window pane. Same thing there. You've got a JRE system library. Now the JRE file is loaded with default JAR file, right? There you go. So it's loaded with default. So Selenium defaults, downloads that. A default for you, right? So that's your system library, and you've got your SRC, which is your source folder, right? So that should be an SRE source folder, right? So now, how to create your Selenium test cases, right? So what you want to do is to So, you write your Selenium test cases, you will have to create a Java class file. And each class file is known as a test case, right? So, you right click on the source folder and select New Class, right? Your new class, your new Java class, which is your test case, the pop-up window will be displayed, right? Now, you have to name your first test case, right? And then you have to select the option of a public static void a main, which is common for writing all Java classes, right? So it's common to all Java test cases, right? And you click Finish. So let's head over to Selenium, and we do that just now. So we right click on the source folder, go to New, go to Class. And here we have to name our first test case, right? So, what does this suggest? First test case. So, we just name that first test case, right? And we select public static void main, which is common to all test cases, right? And we click Finish. Now here to the left pane you've created your first test case, right? So you've created your first test case. Now you can start building your Selenium tests within your templates, right? So within this template, you can start building your test cases, right? So we've already just created our first test case, right? So you can start adding within this template. So the prerequisite before we start writing our Selenium test cases is to have created a connection between Selenium, right, and your Java project. So we haven't downloaded Selenium yet, right? So when we download Selenium in day 4, right, we'll have to create that connection between Selenium and the Java project, right? So give the Java project the Selenium knowledge it needs to execute your test cases. Okay, so that's that for today. It's nice and straightforward. So that's our first project template created, right? This is just a template, so we haven't started writing any code yet, right? So we haven't started automated test cases yet, right? So this is just the template, okay? So don't forget to drop down below and subscribe to the channel, right? Follow the journey, hashtag OASU, hashtag our project, okay? Thank you, and see you in day 4. Thank you, bye.